Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated. Let us pray. Lord, thank you for the opportunity to gather tonight and recognize each of our graduates. We know that every good and perfect gift comes from you. We ask that your faithfulness through 13 years of school is only the beginning of a lifetime of grace, mercy, and provision for the class of 2023. In Jesus' name we ask these things. Amen.
Good evening. On behalf of the faculty and staff of Thorsby High School, welcome to the class of 2023 commencement exercises. At this time, I'd like to invite Corin Kendrick for her salutatory address.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you to all the family, friends, and teachers that are here supporting us as the class of 2023. And most importantly, thank you to our Heavenly Father for blessing each and every one of us with the opportunity to be here tonight. Like every valedictorian and salutatorian ever, I had absolutely no idea what to talk about tonight. Of course, I wanted it to be something memorable but not too sappy, and funny but not too short. And my first thought was of all the graduating Disney movies and episodes. And if you know me, that thought process was not a surprise at all. I then thought of my younger self. How I dreamed of having a high school experience straight out of High School Musical, Suite Life on Deck, or even Wizards of Waverly Place. And even though my vision of randomly breaking into song and dancing in the hallways, or living on a cruise boat together with all my classmates, and even casting spells to always get us to school on time didn't actually happen, we did have our own version of what school looked like for us. We started off with coloring books, learning each other's names, and moving our clothespins to yellow, and sometimes red. We got a little bit older, shared our birthdays together, played together, and even sometimes got hurt together. But no worries, Miss Peggy was always there to save the day with her Vaseline that could literally save lives for anything. We had awkward Valentine's Day dances, endless dodgeball games, where I assume it was only fun to be on the winning team, but I wouldn't know, and PE dance battles that will haunt us forever. If you know, you know. Before we knew it, our lunchtime at 10 in the morning turned to 12 in the day, and we were in high school. From the Coach Jackson life lessons to trying out for new teams and clubs, we were slowly finding out who we were. The JV years flew by, filled with winning games, new friendships, and the beginning of traditions that would create the best memories. And suddenly, we were the cool ones our younger selves always wished to be. Driving to school, checking out early, maybe a little too much of checking out early, and being looked up to by the underclassmen. Through all the famous Coach Wood quotes, endless help from Miss Johnson, and what seemed to be like impossible labs in Miss Caton's class, we managed to grow up without even realizing it. Now here we are. We've spent nearly every day together for the past 13 years. We've learned new things together, been endlessly embarrassed together, and laughed until we've cried together. Now we've grown up together. This may be cliche, but even though our time here at Thorsby High School is over, the bond our class has created will never end. Because a class that learns the Cotton Eye Joe together stays together. On a serious note, I'm proud of us. I wouldn't trade our time here at THS for the world. They say the days are long, but the years are short, and they're right. So I pray that we always go after what we want in life and stay true to what we believe, that we seize the moment and never wait for something to be done, but do it ourselves, that we keep God first always and remember that our lives are in His hands. Thank you, class of 2023, for an unforgettable 13 years. At this time, I would like to invite Misha Milnes to the podium.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Misha Mims, and on behalf of the class of 2023, I'd like to give a warm welcome to all the family, friends, teachers, administration, and staff that joined us today. Thank you for joining us at this unforgettable event. First and foremost, I would like to thank God of joy and hope for helping us get through these past 13 years of school. Second, I would like to thank my wonderful parents, Amanda and Jeremy Mims, for always supporting, encouraging, and motivating me throughout my elementary, middle, and high school career. I will never forget the endless nights they all spent helping me with my homework. Third, I would like to thank my grandfather, Wayne Cummings, and my great-grandfather, Hermes Campbell, for teaching me the value of hard work. Fourth, I would like to thank my grandmothers, Linda Cummings and Janice Mims, and my Aunt Marcia for always being there when I need you the most, and overall being my personal cheerleaders. Fifth, I would like to thank my twin sister, Tori Mims. Thank you for not only being a great sister, but the absolute best friend. Sixth, I would like to thank my wonderful teachers throughout elementary, middle, and high school. Thank you for your hard work, dedication, and passion for teaching. I'll never forget y'all. Thank you. Well, class, we did it. The day we thought would never get here is here, graduation day. Throughout our 13 years of school, we've laughed, cried, and made several unforgettable memories that will truly last a lifetime. I'm honored to stand up here today and talk on behalf of our class. Although, when writing my speech, I realized I could not do so, because we all have different stories. We all had different experiences throughout our 13 years of school. So I decided to ask my fellow classmates if they had any advice for the current and upcoming students of Thorsby High School. And they all said the same thing, which was, don't take time for granted. Enjoy every moment of school that you can, because I promise your graduation day will be here before you know it. So please, take our advice and don't take time for granted, not in high school, not in college, not in anything you do. Thank you. Now, I would like to invite Tori Mims up here to give her valedictorian speech.
Good evening, class of 2023. So I'm about to cry after those two speeches. So I'm going to try to do this real quick before I start bawling up here. So today is a day we will cherish and remember for the rest of our lives. Today is a day we will officially begin our bittersweet journey into adulthood. Before we start our journey, I want to share a piece of advice that has been spoken to me and I believe wholeheartedly. The key to success is not the measurement of intelligence, but the amount of hard work. Anyone can be taught, however, no one can give you a great work ethic. If you are determined and work hard to meet your goals, then you can and will be successful. Because the key to success is determination. I want to take a minute to thank the Lord for placing so many wonderful people in my life. I want to thank Him for placing all the teachers that have helped me throughout my high school and elementary school career. I also want to take a minute to thank Ms. Nunn, our counselor. She has done so much for us throughout the years, from helping us plan for our future and this event today. I also want to take the time to thank my mom and dad for all the late night studying sessions ever since I was in kindergarten. To my older siblings, thank you for the advice you have given me throughout the years. To my twin sister, thank you for always having my back, no matter, and I mean it, no matter the cost. To my brother-in-law, Michael, thank you for being there for me and cheering me up when I am down in the dumps. Thank you for making sure I have some fun and not study all the time. To my aunts, uncles, and grandmothers, thank you for instilling confidence with me by praising me for even the smallest achievements. And thank you, Thorsby High School, for all the wonderful memories, and to my classmates. For the last and final time, go Rebels.
At this time, we'd like to invite our senior sponsor, Mrs. Kim Johnson, to the podium.
K Can you imagine spending 44 years of your life in school? That sounds like a long time. About as long as sitting through one of my lectures on The Outsiders, The Crucible, The Great Gatsby, or Macbeth. Including all the years I have spent in school as a student myself and as a teacher, I have spent 44 of my 49 years in school. I remember coming to Thorsby High School the summer of 2012 to enroll my older two sons. Mr. Russ Bryan met me in the parking lot and said, "You know I have an English position open." I wasn't looking to change schools because at that time, I had already been teaching for 16 years, and 12 of those years I had spent teaching at the school where I grew up. He told me to think about it, so I went home and prayed long and hard. I began to feel God was telling me I needed a change. Sometimes we have to move out of our comfort zone in order to embrace our greatest blessings in life, and I did just that. When I came to Thorsby, I felt as if I were home. I was welcomed by everyone and have always felt as if I were part of a big extended family. I will forever be grateful to Mr. Bryan for giving me the opportunity to find a new home here. After teaching at four different schools over the past 27 years, Thorsby will always be where I consider home. Now, let's go back to those literary works I mentioned, because I feel each one has a valuable lesson for you to remember as you embark on your new endeavors in life. From Macbeth, I hope you remember that it's good to be ambitious, but never let that ambition change who you are and destroy you. From The Great Gatsby, I hope you learned that you can't live in the past and that your past doesn't define who you are because you aren't that person anymore. From The Crucible, I hope you learned how important it is to stand up for what you believe in, no matter the cost. My greatest hope is that you will always cling to Johnny's dying words to Ponyboy and The Outsiders. Stay gold. While one book of your life is ending tonight, you are about to write a new one. And in all those books you will write, they will all come with numerous joys, as well as hardships and obstacles. Don't let those obstacles keep you from becoming your best self. Don't let those hardships harden you and steal your sparkle. Don't let the world change who you truly are and make you feel you are inferior to anyone else. You are fearfully and wonderfully made, and each of you were made with a unique purpose to fulfill in this life. I'd like to think that I have somehow made a small difference in the lives of my students over the years, but if I had listened to the world instead of that still small voice inside my head telling me my purpose, I would have become a lawyer instead of a teacher when I began college at the University of Alabama all those years ago. Roll Tide. I knew I was being called to teach, but I tried to run away from that because I was thinking dollar signs instead of God's will for my life. I have always told my own children that it is fantastic to find a career that brings in a lot of money, but be sure that career is one that is going to bring you joy and happiness as well. While I am wholeheartedly looking forward to retirement, I can't imagine having been anything else but a teacher. I will always be a teacher at heart. I know without a doubt it was God's purpose for my life. I may have never gained financial success from it, but other than being a mother to my boys, teaching has brought me my greatest fulfillment in life. Whatever situation you encounter in life, always remember to stay true to yourself and within the realm of what you were uniquely designed to do in this life. Don't let the world influence you to be someone you aren't made to be. When you feel your world is crumbling around you, stay gold. When you feel you just can't go on another day, stay gold. When you feel you are on top of the world, stay gold. When you feel that everything is finally falling into place, stay gold. When you feel the world is trying to change you into someone you aren't, stay gold, Pony Boy, stay gold. Thank you for allowing me to play just a very small role in your life. I love you all, and I wish you all the very best at everything you do in this life. Thank you.
And Corin Kendrick, she is our president of the senior class, has a token of appreciation from the seniors for all of her hard work as a senior sponsor and their teacher. She is beloved and will be truly missed. And now it's time for the presentation of diplomas. Row one, please stand. Alejandra Jasmine Alcala Moncada. Kanaya Patrice Andrews. Hey, Aaron, I want you to go this way. This way. Jose Aaron Arredondo Sanchez. Kendall Dwayne Braswell. Savannah Brielle Caudle. Bailey Quinn Kleckler. Peyton William Cole. Christopher Joseph Collins. James Dean Cost. Joshua Noah Daniel. Eric Haven Davenport. Madison Brianne Day. Braden Connor Devers. John Levick Dickerson. Row two, please stand. Row one, you can sit down. Michael Ethan Duncan. Savannah Nicole Edge. Jackson Andrew Ellison. Noelia Giselle Flores Aguilar. Manolo Gutierrez Rico. Addison Renee Hayes. Nathaniel Joseph Hogue. Braxton Heath Jones. Corin Faith Kendrick. Cassandra Leah Knox. Daisy Marie Langston. Haley Lynette Maddox. Jordan Elizabeth Massey. Jace Tyler Mims. Misha Daylin Mims. Presley Isabella Mims. Tori Amanda Mims. Maria Jose Morales Flores. Michaela Grace Morrow. Row two, you may be seated. Row three, please stand. Aiden Luke Nyman. Valeria Ordaz Sid. Emily Grace Parker. Joseph Franklin Price. Madeline Rose Ray. Aurelis Lovato Romero. Woo! Julia Fuentes Romero. Felicia Michelle Sanders. Technical difficulty. Nothing to see here. Morgan Lane Scarborough. Garen Leonard Simpson. Bailey Faith Sims. Remington Dwayne Taylor. Ethan Keith Treywick. Jackson Dallas Tucker. Aiden Alexander Turner. Row three, you may be seated. Row four, please stand. Lasha Giselle Vasquez. Lakeland Teresa Williams. And last but not least, Madeline Ruth Woodall. Felicia, we would like for you to come to the stage. Again, you're extra special. Let's give a round of applause. Felicia Sanders.
Graduates, please stand. You may now move your tassels from the right to the left. Congratulations to the class of 2023.